Alright, welcome folks. We are now going to do a full cleansing ritual for our clients. This is going to be a religious cleansing ritual. For right now, what we're going to do is we're going to start with our oil. We're going to oil the door. In the name of Jesus Christ, we ask for your protection. Cleanse this portal coming into the house. Let no evil pass through here. Let no negative energies pass through here. Let no unwanted spirits, unwantedness, anything that's unwanted or undesired, come through this portal. Protect it. Protect the home now. Dousing it with oil, olive oil all the way to the floor, across the floor. Your hands do get dirty, and we cleanse each corner of the door. To this door. The doors are called portals in some instances. This is preventing any evil coming into the home. You do it all the way down. Watching, of course, not to get slivers in your hands. To the window. Anything was to attack me, they would be coming through the doorway. Yeah, stand back a little with that. Back. Stop. Right there is fine. So, let me do the windows. Sometimes on the windows you will find nails or anything. Now we see that this is duct taped here. We see that there's some hole here. I'm not going to worry about those right now. And now we have done the oil. And now, as you can see, my hands are greasy and messy, and that comes with the territory here. I'm going to pick up those for them. What we're going to do now is I'm going to pray over the salt in the name of Jesus Christ. We ask you to protect this salt. We ask that this salt is used and only in your name and only for protection for our clients today. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray, amen. And the reason we're using the name clients is because I've already prayed for them. We've already acknowledged them. They wish to remain anonymous. They've given permission for us to do the video. So it's just salt. And as I go through it, you can see that it's regular salt. And what I'm going to do is you don't throw it in the bed. Back up with a little video to there. Alright, the reason I'm telling him to back up also, because he tends to follow, and sometimes something may happen. I'm feeling cold right now as I do this. So we're going to start with the bottom of the bed. I'm going to sprinkle the salt around it. Maybe a little greasy and chunky, but that's okay. I'm going to try not to get around the sheets as I go to the top and work my way back to the bottom. Okay, that's how I do it. You're up. Making sure I get everywhere where something could step. It spreads out very easily. As I go to the back here, I'm going to get around everything. They have their household items here that we're going to move out of the way. Sprinkling around the bed for protection. Now, a lot of people say, well, why do you use salt? Well, salt is a good protective area. We're going to salt a little bit in the path to the bed. In the path, salt a little to the path to the door. So that if anything does come in, then they could clean it. A lot of people do clean it up after a while. But that is this room. Now, where he is standing is also salted to the path to the door. So that is this room. I'm going to finalize it with a prayer. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for this room, that all who enter shall enter peacefully. All who enter and commune in this room, for whatever purpose they may have in this room, they are done. It is done. It shall be done peacefully. No negativity in this room. No evil. No unwanted spirits. No unwanted activities. Only peace for this room. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. That is the blessing of this room. The bed, the doors. Okay. Some things like TVs and clothes, you don't have to bless. A bed is protection for if anything comes at night. The door, the entranceway where people may walk. What happens sometimes is they will take the salt on their shoes. And they will take it with them, and that protection is on the bottom of their feet when they walk. All right, that is this room. We're going to go on to now the next room. All right, we're in a child's bedroom right now. What we're going to do is the same thing. We're going to oil the door. Oil the door. Okay. Enter. And a lot of people do both sides of the door. I really don't have to because it's an entrance from the door inside the thing here. Alright. And then we're going to oil the window. Child's room, extra protective.
extra protection here.
Now, we may notice if you look up, there is a large gap in the ceiling. It was made when a repair to the light, something wasn't right, and they haven't gotten the tiles back up. So we're going to do a little bit here. Okay. Just around the edges a little. I don't really want to get whatever's up there.
Down here.
And since this is a child's bedroom, I am going to do the walls. So that helps. The walls are a protection for them as well. Okay. Now, we're going to salt. Now, how I'm going to salt in here is the bed is going to stay where it is. I've explained to the homeowner about moving the bed around with the kid. So we're going to do our best to make sure that the child doesn't move. A lot of times the children, they move stuff. They play or whatever you want to call it. So stand over here. And we're going to start right here. I'm going to do the same thing we've done in other areas. Assault. Around the thing, try not to get the toys. If we get the toys, it's okay. Unlike the parents, sometimes a little extra protection on the toys is good. Down here a little bit. Work around the toys. See around here in the bottom. There's some toys, so I'm going to do the best I can to work around them. Protection for the doorway. Videotape this way. This way. Doorway and close. And again, it's a child. We're going to work our way right into the kitchen. I can videotape right there. Just keep doing it. With a kitchen. I don't like to get it on the floor, but we do see a portal, a window. So what we're going to do is we're going to cleanse this window here. We can. I don't know if they still use it, but other than here, it's used. Alright, I'm going to do the wall here. Now there's a place of food. Now I see another pantries and all that. There's a bathroom. Well, we're gonna do that. I do one side of the door for now. Because it is the entrance to the place. That needs something. You can get in. And we don't want them to get in. While we're here, we're gonna wash my hands real quick. And a bit oily. Well, that is the blessing and cleansing all in one area, all in one setting, if you will, all at one time for you. We're going to do other things, but for right now, we have videotaped this part of it. I will be coming back with more as we do it.